We all have a set of instructions within each cell that tells us how our body will behave with the surroundings. Understanding these instructions helps us to uncover underlying mysteries of life that can range from health to evolutionary science. In this video, we are going to talk about the Human Genome Project and discuss more on Human Genome, the project, how it was done, and finally, the achievements and challenges associated to this project. And so, let's start with the video. Our body is made up of several cells, approximately 17 trillion to 36 trillion cells. This cell count varies based on the age, gender, and size. Each of these cells, except few, contain nucleus within which lies deoxyribonucleic acid, or DNA for short. DNA is a hereditary material in humans and other organisms. It is a double helical structure with two strands. Each of its strands has many nucleotides, and each nucleotide has following things in them. Firstly, a sugar or the deoxyribose, then a phosphate group, and lastly, any one of these nitrogenous bases, which are adenine, guanine, cytosine, and thymine. Only specific segments of all collective DNA hold hereditary information. This is also known as genes. All the genes, along with non-coding regions of DNA, together make up the human genome. Understanding what our genes are and how it affects us can bring about massive benefit to humanity. But before we could reach to such levels of technological capacity, we first needed to sequence the entire human genome. And this is exactly how the Human Genome Project, a public initiative, began in the 1990s through the collaborative efforts of global research institutions and experts from various scientific fields. The Human Genome Project aimed to identify, map, and sequence all human genes, ultimately decoding the entire genome. As per National Human Genome Research Institute, genome is a set of all DNA instructions found in a cell. It contains all the information needed for an individual to develop and function. The human genome consists of approximately 3.1 billion base pairs, organized into 23 chromosomes. Since human cells are diploid, containing two sets of chromosomes, one from each parent, they carry about 6.2 billion base pairs of DNA in total. The Human Genome Project was a 13-year-long publicly funded initiative that began in 1990. Initially projected to cost $3 billion and take 15 years, the project was completed ahead of schedule on April 14, 2003 and under budget at around $2.7 billion. It was formally founded by the US Department of Energy and the National Institute of Health. David Kallis led the Department of Energy side and James Watson headed the National Institute of Health effort. In 1993, Aristides Petronos replaced Kallis and Francis Collins succeeded Watson as the overall director. A working draft of human genome was released in 2000, published in 2001, and the final version was completed in 2003, with fine-tuning continuing for years after. Alongside this project, a similar project was carried out by Celera Corporations, or Celera Genomics, in 1998. Most of the HGP sequencing was performed in 20 universities and research centers in the United States, the United Kingdom, Japan, France, Germany, and China. The idea of sequencing the human genome took shape in the mid-1980s. Robert Sinsheimer, a molecular biologist, organized a workshop at University of California, Santa Cruz to discuss creating a reference genome. Renato Dalbecco, a cancer researcher at Salk Institute for Biological Studies, wrote in an academic journal named Science that sequencing the genome could revolutionize cancer research. Around the same time, Charles DeLisi from the US Department of Energy proposed and funded the first official plan. His actions directly led to the launch of the Human Genome Project. Most of the original human genome sequence came from volunteers in Buffalo, New York, through research at Roswell Park Cancer Institute. While DNA from 20 anonymous donors was used, about 70% of reference genome came from one individual of mixed ancestry, with the rest from others, mainly of European descent. To sequence the human genome, scientists used a method called hierarchical shotgun sequencing. First, the genome was broken into large pieces, about 150,000 base pairs long, and inserted into bacterial artificial chromosomes, or BAC, which were placed into bacteria for replication. These BACs form the physical map of the genome. From this map, a minimal set of overlapping fragments called a telling part was selected. Each BAC was broken into smaller pieces, sequenced using the Sanger method, and assembled. This approach, though slow and labor-intensive, was reliable before computing power improved enough to support whole genome shotgun sequencing. In June 2000, the International Human Genome Sequencing Consortium, or the IHGSC, announced the release of a draft version of the human genome, covering around 90% of the total sequence. However, this version included over 150,000 gaps where the exact DNA sequence could not yet be determined. By April 2003, the IHGSC revealed an essentially complete human genome, a major improvement over the earlier draft. This version covered approximately 92% of the genome, had fewer than 400 remaining gaps, and offered greater sequencing accuracy. With the human genome now sequenced, scientists focus on identifying genetic variation that increase the risk of common diseases like cancer and diabetes, thus narrowing the research focus towards understanding disease at the genetic level. This project saw collaboration of experts from different fields, including scientific communities and experts from humanities and social science. Along with identifying all of the approximately 20,000 to 25,000 genes in human genome, the Human Genome Project also sought to address ethical, legal, and social issues associated to this project. Although Human Genome Project is officially complete, scientists still face many challenges in fully understanding what the genome means. About 1% of the genome, mostly in hard-to-sequence region called heterochromatin, remains unfinished. These areas might or might not contain important genes, and studying them will require more advanced sequencing tools. Another big challenge is figuring out how genes are controlled. Many of the signals that switch genes on or off are still unknown. Researchers are also trying to understand how chemical changes to DNA, like methylation, affect how genes work and how they influence health and disease. The project also found over 1.4 million SNPs, or single nucleotide polymorphisms, which are tiny differences in a single DNA letter between people. Even though humans share 99.9% of the DNA, these small changes can influence disease risk, drug response, and how we react to the environment. Now scientists are focused on finding which of these genetic differences truly matter. They are also working to understand what each gene does, since the protein made by genes are worth actually carrying out vital tasks in the body. To conclude, Human Genome Project was a mega project that brought in significant changes on scientific approach towards research. Beyond successfully mapping most of the human genome, it fostered unprecedented global collaboration not only among scientists but also experts from fields like social science and humanities. With that being said, what is your opinion on Human Genome Project? Feel free to share your thoughts. Until then, see you in the next video.